Santosh A.T. Pednekar, Secretary Industries and Managing Director, RICO, to address. Mr. Pednekar is a senior IAS official and has held many important positions with state government. Mr. Pednekar is the official who is leading Invest Rajasthan from government. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Sabuji. Honorable Industries and Commerce Minister of the Government of Rajasthan, Madam Shakuntala Rawatji, Additional Chief Secretary of the Government of Rajasthan, Subrat Singh Mann, Madhavji, Singhaniaji, Sabuji, Rumkaji, Javaji, Dhiraji, Mayangji, and most of all and most importantly, all the esteemed investors who have gathered over here in such large numbers and friends of the media. It's really heartening to see such a tremendous response for our first roadshow, the first domestic roadshow that we are undertaking under the Invest Rajasthan campaign that we are having. And it's really great to see such a flying start that we have received for this domestic roadshow that we are having. We'll be having 28 such events throughout the country, in 28 cities throughout the country, where we are aggressively kind of inviting investment to come to the state of Rajasthan. And as was just described, we just last month had a roadshow in Dubai, which got, that was an international roadshow, which got a tremendous response. So all in all, it's really wonderful to see that we have got on to a good start as far as the Invest Rajasthan Summit is concerned. The Invest Rajasthan Summit is the most important event in the official calendar of the Government of Rajasthan. So no wonder the department is, the Industries and Commerce Department, is putting in a lot of effort to ensure that it becomes a success. But what I would like to inform you is, it's not just the Industries and Commerce Department which is doing it under the leadership of our Chief Minister. What is happening is that all of government approach is currently being undertaken. So all the departments of the state of Rajasthan, they have all got on to get investment into the state. And it's not just the departments, but the entire administrative machinery up to the district levels have all been engaged in this summit. There are certain unique things which are happening as far as the Invest Rajasthan Summit is concerned. There are other states which also hold summits, but out here there are certain things this time which are being done which are pretty unique. So even as we have our investment summit in Jaipur on the 24th and 25th, each of the 33 districts of Rajasthan, they are all holding their own investment summits. So you'll have a Invest Bhilwara, a Invest Pali, a Invest Jodhpur, a Invest Jaisalmer, where every district is kind of looking at itself as a business unit or a strategic business unit, as a profit center or as an investment center, and going out and getting investment into the district. And this is their approach, and we have been doing it for the about last couple of months. And the kind of enthusiasm that we have seen from the district machinery under the leadership of the district collector, the minister in charge, the secretary in charge, is quite tremendous. So this is an experiment that we are doing for the first time in the country, and I hope it will lead to some pretty good results. Also, what we are doing is that from the 1st January to the 15th of January, as a build-up to the 24th and 25th event of Invest Rajasthan, all the departments, the major departments of the state, which actually help in getting investment, they are all holding their own summits. So they'll have one particular day where, let's say, the Energy Department or the Mines and Minerals Department or the UDH Department, they'll hold the summit where they'll get the MOUs and LOIs, and they'll be signed exclusively on that particular day. Another unique thing which is happening is, so rather than signing all the MOUs and LOIs on the day of the summit, as we are seeing right now, as we'll be doing very shortly, we are signing all of them as a prelude to the event. The idea behind this is that we would like to convert as many MOUs and LOIs into an actual groundbreaking to happen in the next couple of months, so that on the 24th and 25th, we can concentrate to ensure that your projects actually get on the ground as quickly as possible. So it serves as a pressure on us to ensure that all your clearances, etc., are given as quickly as possible. And the way the MOU and LOI has been done, so for today, for example, we are signing MOUs and LOIs worth 75,000 crore rupees today, and we are signing about 145 of them. And the way it works is that the memorandum of understanding is signed with those companies which already have the land with them. And the letter of intent is taken from those companies which currently do not have the land with them. They have the intention of investing in the state, but we would like to assist the companies in getting the land. So out of the 75,000 crore rupees of investment that is coming today, is I'm happy to kind of inform you that 65,000 crore rupees are MOUs. That is, they have the land available with them, and the rest 10,000 crore rupees are letters of intent. So the whole idea is that we would like to focus, so on the 24th and 25th, on very large number of groundbreaking ceremonies and inaugurations of companies and factories, etc. And over and apart from that, even the infrastructure works of the government, etc., are going to be launched on the 24th of January. So this is also a pretty unique thing in that respect. Another thing that I would like to kind of inform you is that the government of Rajasthan has now been putting a lot of emphasis on the enabling infrastructure that is required to get industry inside the state. And what is happening is that we are leveraging large strategic projects like the dedicated freight corridor, which were mentioned earlier. The DFC project, the dedicated freight corridor project, is the largest of its kind in the country. And I'm happy to report that we are the first state in the country to operationalize the largest stretch. We have the largest stretch, and we're the first to operationalize that particular stretch. The reason why this is important is because this is important from the logistics point of view. Logistics is an important cost, an important factor in production. And now this has given us direct connectivity to the ports of Western India. And that is very important. As you can understand, you're all industrialists and you're all from the industry. You understand the importance of this. We also have important projects like the Delhi-Mumbai Expressway and the Amritsar-Jamnagar Expressway. These are greenfield projects. So how this is helping us is this is opening up the hinterland of the state for investment. And we are now leveraging this in collaboration with the government of India. We are working very closely with the government of India to ensure that these projects are done, are brought on the ground as quickly as possible and new investment comes in. You must have also heard of the Delhi-Mumbai Industrial Corridor. I also happen to be commissioner of the Delhi-Mumbai Industrial Corridor. And we have a partnership with the center where we have a 49-51% partnership, where we have 51% and the center has contributed 49%. And two major world-class industrial townships are coming in. One is called the Greater Bhiwadi Industrial Township, and the other is the Marwad Industrial Cluster. The company is in the process of being formed. I think next week the company will be formed. And we are talking of $1 billion each of investment in the GBIT as well as the MIC. And the infrastructure that will be coming in these townships will be second to none. And so I'm just explaining this to you because these are great investment opportunities which are available to potential investors. Another important opportunity which is also there is in the petrochemicals and the petroleum field. So we have the petrol zone which is coming up in Pachpadra. We have a $7 billion refinery, one of the largest of its kind in the world, which is coming up in Pachpadra. And now, because of that, the downstream petrochemicals, petroleums, and chemical industries will come up in the surrounding areas. We have taken up a major land bank in the PCPI region of Pachpadra, and that's again another major opportunity which is there. Mayank has already told about the great opportunities which are available in the renewable energy field. We are the topmost leaders, not just in the country, but in the world in terms of the kind of low cost of renewable energy that you have in the state of Rajasthan. So the result of all this has been that in terms of infrastructure, the state of Rajasthan has been growing at a very rapid pace. And the Chief Minister made a very important announcement in the last budget, where he said that in all the blocks of Rajasthan, there has to be an industrial area in all the blocks of Rajasthan. So because of which, what has happened is, this year we'll be opening up 120 new industrial areas throughout the state. This would happen in this year itself. And to put it in context and to put it in perspective, the state of Rajasthan on an average would open about 3 to 4 industrial areas per annum. So we are now talking of a jump from 3 to 4 to 120 throughout the state just this year itself. And the result of this has been that our industrial infrastructure, which is very important to get all of you there and to, you know, to ensure that your investment is safe and secure and also actually grows, our infrastructure has really improved by leaps and bounds. Just this year, the government of India, along with the Asia Development Bank, they did a survey of the top 1,500 industrial areas of the entire country, of which they selected 65 in the leader category of the entire country, 65 industrial areas in the leader category.
So out of the 65 in the entire industrial areas, 28 were from Rajasthan. So that shows you the sheer numbers, the quality of the infrastructure of the state. And RICO as an organization is in charge of the industrial infrastructure development of the state. I'm again happy to report to you that last year in a competition, because COCTC is an organization of all the SIDCs of the country, where we go head on head against all the SIDCs of the country, maybe all the best of the SIDCs. And last year RICO was rated as the number one SIDC of the country. And all how this has helped is just to kind of indicate the kind of investor interest which is coming into the state. On an average, RICO would sell about 250 industrial plots per annum, on an average. But after this aggressive push which has happened in the infrastructure sector, in the year 2019-20, RICO sold 1,224 plots. In the year 2021, it sold 2,863 plots. And this year, we are going to sell, we are currently on track to sell more than 5,000 plots. So what is happening is, the reason I'm telling you these numbers is because they actually give you a kind of an objective idea about the sheer amount of investor interest which is coming to the state of Rajasthan. So we are talking of a 20x increase in just 2 years in the state of Rajasthan. And that is the reason why we requested the government that more and more land should be allotted to RICO and to the industries department, so that we can offer that land to potential investors, so that more investors can come and get the land at very competitive and attractive prices. And I'm happy to report, because of the sheer support that we have got from the government, as well as, and more importantly, from the revenue department of the government of Rajasthan, we currently have the largest land bank which is there anywhere in the country, which is meant for the industrial purposes. So all in all, what I would like to just say is, first of all, thank you for coming here in such large numbers. We look forward to partnering with you to ensure that the state of Rajasthan and both of us together are actually able to get not just investment, but to ensure that your investment grows and you profit out of it, and we become a new industrial powerhouse of the country. And we look forward to your continuous association. Thank you very much once again. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Pednekar. Friends, Mr. Pednekar has always been very innovative.